Demon Souls until 5 o'clock Pacific, so about a little longer than an hour and a half. I think that I'm going to go try to fight the false idol again, the lady boss. I've been poring over it in my head since Tuesday, like, what did I miss? And I think the key thing that I didn't do was he said something like, you know, I'm up above or something, I'm up here. And I climbed one of the staircases and just got to a dead end, but I never checked the other staircase. So I'm going to go check that out and we'll see what happens. And then we'll move on maybe back to the world with that the adjudicator was in. Thank you, Knight, for the host. Someone could throw a... Oh, this is the dude we rescued, isn't it? Does he sell something or something?
I'm glad I found you. I found some really nice trinkets.
Nice.
Well, we've been long acquainted, so I'm willing to part with them at a special price.
They better not actually mean today. Patches, man. Fragrant ring. Okay, MP recovery, but we don't really have anything that uses MP at the time. Add a bunch of grass. Now, I haven't done any
do as you please.
Grass farming today, so I might end up having to do that if we get into a fight that's really hard. I have a little bit left over from last session. I wasn't expecting to play today. I thought Ghost Trick was going to be a little bit longer. But we'll see. The best merchant for grass? Okay, and he's there for the rest of the game now that we've bet him, Serpent. Fantastic. 1,000, super cheap for that good one. That's like 7 grass per Reaper kill if we go back to the farming spot that we opened up recently. Yeah, that makes sense, sure. Alright, I'm gonna see if I can remember. It's been a while since we were here. I still have a good mental map of this place. I really like the tone of the zone. It's really cool on the hoe. That's right, this is the dragon sword he's got. Oh, actually, this. Did we hit him the first time? Shit, we're super dead. Super dead! That's okay. Open with a pretty good you died. Womp womp. That's right, we're playing Demon Souls, not Super Mario Brothers. You can't just bolt through an area thoughtlessly. Alright, let's go actually kill that guy this time. Yeah, if you want to evade, that's fine. Go for it. Do I have to be in body form for invasions to work in this one? I'm not sure how they handled that in this game. I think I've asked before, but I'm still not 100% sure. Wonk. I think that in the past I've gone through this part slightly more slowly, which actually makes it possible for you to backstab this guy outside here. Try doing that. Let's wait a sec. I think he heard me. Maybe not. Okay, that'll do. Good job done. Should be able to sneak up on this guy, no problem, right? Yeah, it's the ticket. Yeah. Upside down difficulty curves, man. I don't know how to do it. I'm not sure why it happens, actually. Like, if it's the developers just kind of design the whole game assuming that you're at the end game and don't have all of your tools available to you. I feel like that requires a developer to look at their game very closely and say, you know what, we're actually going to go out of our way to make the beginning a little bit easier. Just so that the start of it isn't so hard, like it isn't Final Fantasy Tactics or Earthbound or any other RPG. I feel like it's fairly unique to RPGs. You don't really see it so much in other games. Maybe a little bit in this one, like once you get regeneration, that's pretty strong. Alright, so I believe that I went up the staircase on the left, but I never tried the staircase on the right. So that's what I'm going to do. Maybe there's like a switch or an item or something that I have to pull up there. I see. Yeah, if you try to do like jack of all trades. I also don't know if there's more enemies we have to worry about up here. I suppose we'll find out soon enough. You ever come up here? I see, sure. Yeah, there's totally a dude back there. Why did I never check this place? I'm just bad. Oh, no, we did see this guy.
What do you want? I am a humble servant. I do not wish to interfere. I won't cause you trouble. I won't.
You're not going to cause me trouble, huh? What does this say? Critical attack. Liar. Man, there must have been notes like that when I played it the first time and I just ignored them, huh? So maybe his little yellow thing is like what resummons her when she dies. Yeah, and I guess I just didn't come. I was like, oh yeah, I already checked up the top. And I just ignored the guy, huh? Is he permanently dead now? Well, I guess we'll go fight her and see if that actually ends it or not, or if we have to do it again. Oh shit, could be death. Yeah, I was trying to drop on the little thing. I'm gonna check up top. Oh, that's right! Yeah, the Demon Soul servers were down when I first visited Latria, so I didn't have any messages to give me a hint. Okay, that makes sense. Yeah. It would be cool if there was a developer message there that said something similar. So, we'll see if he respawned. I mean, I guess if you want to save me some time, if you know that he's permanently dead, just give me a heads up. But I assume that he's back, and I have to kill him and kill her. Being all fancy, trying to take a shortcut, was killed. Got 6 half-moon grasses, which hopefully will be enough for this boss fight. She was pretty tough last time, but certainly not impossible. Guess we'll probably want to go up there to get one. It's a small number of souls. Souls are souls. Oh shit, you're usually supposed to be turned away! Oh god! I'm so super dead. Now I'm super dead for reals. Now I think my regeneration's gonna carry me back downstairs. So I've learned a lesson with those guys. Like, at first I thought that once they sucked your brain out that it was just GG. But the idea is that you shouldn't be mashing the attack button once they suck your brain. You should mash roll to get out of the way from them so that you can finish them off. I was doing it wrong before. I was thinking that once I came out of the mind suck that I could maybe hit him a couple times and stagger them. Okay. So I'll have to decide if I ultimately want to use... Is that the dragon sword that I have? Is that upgradable? I'm trying to decide if I want to continue using it. You lived. Cool, and the time it's going to take us to get back up there, grab our souls, and check on the dead person, we'll get our health back. It can be upgradable? Okay, cool. It would be nice to have a weapon that does fire damage. I don't know if we're going to run into anything that requires it. Yeah, it's really easy to get lost here. I like the overhead swing on the bastard sword, though. That's going to make it tough. It's got... Well, let's see. What's the two-handed? It's like a forward slash. And the regular one... Oh, the regular one's overhand. Well, I'll think about it. Hey, Death Ghost. I am, 36. Souls. Probably not going to be using them. I think he's dead, actually. Interesting. You only have to kill him once. Deceptive cuteness. Liar. Yeah, I wonder if I would have figured it out then. So that's kind of cool. I think if I had visited here and then fought the boss in the same session, I would have remembered that he was up there and gone and wrecked him. But I completely forgot about him being there and the little spell he was casting, since there was like a week between when I first visited here and the second time. So I think we're good to go beat this boss. I'm not going to try to take the shortcut because I'm probably just going to fall to my death. Hey Luo, how's it going? Happy Friday, or probably Saturday. Let's get dangerous. Let's go make this happen. We know her tricks. I assume there's still going to be like bloodstains on the floor where we have to worry about getting zapped. We know which one is the real one. She's the one that does the big nuke. Hey, favorite customer, how's it going? Kitties are on the couch again. Do I want to use an ephemeral eyes? I've got it in my bar. I'll use it when I take damage. May as well get another benefit out of it. Skip the cutscene because we've already seen it. I think we still want to kill all these worshippers so they don't get in our way, you know? Awesome. I've actually already beaten this boss, favorite, but I hadn't killed the guy upstairs, so she respawned. And when I came in to fight her again, she kicked my ass. It was kind of a bummer. But I was thinking about it off stream. Last time I played was this past Tuesday. Trying to figure out what I could do differently. Whoa! Alright, that's not a good way to start. I guess we could always abuse regeneration. Just chill behind a pillar. Always get three hits off, which is nice. Watch for bloodstains. See if she's real, I'm not sure. I got too close to that one. Oh, I see. You can see the traps. She's the one all the way in the back. Nice! Looking good so far. I'm gonna break some of those chairs. Okay, she's the one. Okay, let's see if we can figure out who's real this time. Not her. There are four of them now? Oh shit, there was a thing right there. I'm gonna get rocked. Oh, is that enough? Alright! The demon was destroyed, so she's actually for reals dead this time. Hooray! I didn't have to use my ephemeral eyes or any of my grass. When I fought her last time, there was a voice, like there was a character who was talking at the end, and he said something about coming up here. Last session that I played, I tried checking up top, but I went on the wrong side. Like, I went on the left and not the right. This time I went on the right, and I saw a bunch of messages from other players saying that the guy was a liar, so... And I saw that he was casting a little spell. When I played it for the first time, when I first did this level, the Demon Souls servers were down, so there weren't any messages when I bumped into that guy. I forgot about him. Oh, that's cool. Are they gonna carry me away like the little session in Dark Souls? I like all the stuff in Dark Souls that's kind of calling back to Demon Souls. The dragon on the bridge, the design style of the asylum demon, the winged creatures flying you away. Developer messages as well. Oh, I think I must have missed that. There was something that said something about the voice, and I actually misunderstood that. I thought they were talking about the lady who's, like, singing. The opera lady, so I got thrown off and went back and checked that. I think what they meant was the voice coming from the top level. That was my first guess, is it probably has something to do with something on the top level. I just didn't check both sides because I'm dumb. After I got distracted by the check out the opera prisoner lady, I was like, well, I'll just come back to this level later after I've had time to think about it, rather than beat my head against the wall on stream. Soul of the lost withdrawn from its art thou done, main died.
Hi.
One track minder. Bastard sword plus 5, so it's to go. Melbert. Ooh, I can upgrade the bow. Costs hardstone though, and I'm kind of low on that.
I can tell you're not gonna last long here.
They're up above. Oh, I see. Yeah, when I actually fought her for the first time, I did have player hints, so there were a lot of messages on the floor. I didn't know which one was which. All right, let's progress further in Latria. I really like the zone. I'm curious to see what's next. I'm gonna have to put some distance between right now and going back to World 4. I beat the Adjudicator, but the next section, like, I think I just have to have the courage to push through the Ghost and Reaper area. That's a lot of bloodstains. Bloodstains are super helpful in this one. Great view. Cool. Nice. A weak guy lies in wait ahead. Actually, I didn't get to see where that bloodstain died. That looks like death. That looks like progress. That's death. What's over this one? Hidden foe. Oh, it's the flying thing. What's up? These things are freaky deaky. They're way taller than the similar ones in Dark Souls. Phew. I like how they blend in with the dark background. It's cool. Alright. Got time for you. Whoa. Dark wings, dark words. Come on. Stagger is pretty good with this thing, so I can kind of stun lock him. Got enough stamina for 3 consecutive hits. Try to watch. I see some red eyes there in the far distance. That little heartbeat sound effect. Lure it out. I still have my note to get my BPM meter set up. Heart rate monitor. My plan was to do it for next week, though, so it's not out just yet. Death Ghost has invaded? Oh shit, this is my first invader. Okay. Not sure how invasions are in this one. I can't hit them while they're down? That's a bummer. Can you use moongrass? Apparently, yes. Got a full heal out of it, too. I'm guessing he's also immune to the enemies, so he's going to try to lure me into the enemies here. Give himself an advantage. That's okay. We can just wait for him to come back. It might be, I'm not sure. It doesn't give him a name in this one, does it? At some point, I guess I'm just going to have to follow him, especially if he's in chat and knows that I'm waiting to draw him out, you know? I guess he was running away past the enemy so he could heal to full, sure. You haven't invaded in yet? Yeah, let me see if I can draw this mob out real quick. Yep, come on. Still coming? Hey, hey. Assuming that I'm going to ultimately die because I'm going to have to deal with an enemy as well as him at the same time, you know? I also don't know anything about this map. And the sound effects here are super creepy. Something out of Silent Hill, you know? Yeah, cool. There are demons nearby. He's just gonna be able to out-heal me no matter what I do, you know? A poison? Oh, that's a bummer. And so it ends. Congratulations to the invader. I don't know if I could have beaten you, though, because I think that you would be able to outheal any of the damage that I could do with my build. But very good job. Alright, we should be able to get our souls back. It's too bad I don't have the BPM meter turned on. It gets really high when I'm doing invader battles. Yeah, GG. There's a couple dudes here we gotta deal with. Oh, I like how there's two gargoyles there. I didn't notice that last time. One of them is real. I don't think I ever had anyone on the stream invade me when I played Dark Souls. That's kinda cool. My world tendency just took a tanking too, didn't it? Forgot about that. Because I was in body form after beating the boss. There's another dude down this way I want to draw out and murder. Yeah, the atmosphere here is like even creepier than the prison itself was, which is really cool. Here, buddy. Yep. Oh, no stagger. Yeah, I agree, Luo. I like that about Dark Souls, though. It's has a kind of side horror theme. Doesn't update till I go back to the Nexus. Oh, that's interesting. Okay. Souls back. There's a lot of them, but... it's Old Spice. There's an item that I may have skipped as well. Don't roll off the ledge, that would be bad. Yeah, the sound design here is just on point. Oh. Did they mean by up? Oh. looks like that's attached to something. Gross. I need to buy some more arrows as well. I'm not sure if... Did the merchant that I met in the fourth world, did he move to the Nexus? Can I buy from him there, or do I have to go back to his world to buy from him? This guy seems pretty resilient, being knocked off the ledge, unlike their counterparts in Dark Souls. Their corpses aren't, though. Rolling off ledges is bad for business, I would agree. Hi. As that person just did. Renowned heroes. I like heroes. I like souls. Oh, hey. What's up, friend? We have arrows? That's rude. You like to stay back and shoot at me. Well, that makes sense. Why don't you... Can I, like, LOS them and make them come close? Yes, I can. And they have fewer hit points, which generally is true of ranged enemies in this game. I really appreciate that. Let me adjust it. I think it's set for mods only right now. That's what that percent is. If you have to edit it, just do percent 1, and then it will be anyone can proc it. You should still be the only one that's allowed to edit it, though, I think. Try now. Yeah, that's what that percent 8 did. Alright. Percent 1 is everybody. This Moonlight Stone, which we'll eventually use to convert. We're going to turn our rapier into a magic weapon. Or maybe does the Bastard Sword have to get the plus 6 to upgrade to magic as well? Is that the threshold for anything being a magic weapon? It's plus 6. I'm gonna try going up. There's more stairs in there. I say this place is creepier than just about any area in Dark Souls, too. Go. Please recommend this message. You jump down from here, really? Oh, well, maybe you can actually make that. I don't know what it's gonna lead to though, if there's like an item or something. Oh, there's an item there. Okay. Well, good looking out, Tip. I've had remarkably bad luck with falling where I want to fall to. I keep overshooting it a teensy bit. I was worried it was going to happen there, too. Maybe that's what the up was pointing to, this guy. Ooh, rune sword and rune shield. I think I already killed the ranged guy here, so I can take a look at what that item is. Rune sword. Magic damage. Fantastic. Then I don't have to upgrade one. It's a legendary hero's weapon that forms a matching set with a shield. Okay. I'm probably going to keep the Adjudicator shield. Protects user magical attacks. I'd rather have the stacking region. I might try that in place of the dragon sword. Oh, wait, really? Oh, I need points in... What is that stat? I need to put points in magic to be able to use it. Like 8 points in magic. Yikes. Okay. Well, in that case, we'll... Keep the dragon sword for now. Maybe we'll change our approach on that later. I think we want to drop down where it's safe, where we've got the item. That's a lot of stat investment to use a weapon that... Actually, I'm curious is if we upgrade the rapier, the mailbreaker, I mean, or the bastard sword to a magic weapon, is that going to also confer a magic stat requirement onto it? Maybe I should start putting points in that now if I want to be able to use any of it. Sick. Thanks, Cat Cam. Hey, Ben. He's soft and also. It's true. Oh, it won't actually require the stats? Good to know. Up. Oh, thank you. Good way to hide that. Oh shit, that thing hits really hard if you let it hit you, which I haven't really done up till now. Come on, buddy. I really like the design on these guys, like something out of Fantasia. Oh, they have a long strike and a short strike, it looks like. Phew! Some souls, which I don't think I've used a single consumable soul in this playthrough yet, so it'll be nice when it gets to the point that it matters. Hey, hey, mama, say the way. Whoa, you're a ranged attacker. Phew. You'll find a weapon past here. Ooh. Right on. Is that like a strength-based two-handed sword or something? It is a dex-based sword. Oh, it causes bleeding. Mm. I thought those were like big heavy swords. I'm surprised that's a dex requirement. Maybe that's just true of swords in general in this game. Question becomes, can we climb back on there without dying? Looks like that's a one-way trip. Okay, phew! Yeah, no, I hear you, Spiky, exactly. Another one of these buttheads. Beware of false messages. There's another fog door. I see another guy up top as well. Holy souls. Alright, let's try to lure out the guy that's hanging out up here. Come on. Iframes. I'm lost. See another guy flying up there. I'm curious if he's gonna come down when I try to get that item on the edge. I probably have to go through the fog gate to be able to even walk along it without dying. I think that's what's gonna happen. It doesn't come down. Oh, I could have just got there the easy way. Okay. Well, shit happens. Alright. Running bloodstain. Don't know what killed him. Behind you. Oh, shit! That was not behind me. That was in front of me. I think I got so spooked that I accidentally ate a grass. Beware of false messages. I wonder if they ever do any developer false messages like that. We'll find sparkly things past here. Let me see. Maybe I want to go on the other side there. Let me kill this thing first, though. To worry about him now. I really love this game. This series is just so good. Hey, there's our sparkly thing. We got some ephemeral lines. Cool. So in Dark Souls, humanities are kind of hard to come by at the beginning of the game. And then at about the 30% mark or so, there's a place where you can farm them, not terribly efficiently with the rats. And then much later in the game, it becomes very easy to farm them. Is the same thing true of this game? Are you eventually able to farm for stones of ephemeral eyes? Is there like an enemy that drops them? Hey, y'all look like you're up to... seems like a good idea, whatever you're doing. We've learned that harmless prisoners casting spells aren't so harmless. You're gonna put me on a mission of not being a good person anymore. I'm glad that I didn't kill the guy in the false idol fight. Or whatever her actual name is. Oh, maybe that was a bad decision. Holy shit, that's really cool. What a like fancy switch, basically, right? One enemy drops a maiden. Let's see. Yeah, because I guess if you just killed that guy when you went up there the first time, you wouldn't know. If you have White Soul tendency, you can proceed. I do not. Is that something that a player can enter, or is that a developer message? The thing about White Soul tendency. May as well come up and try to pick up an item here. Prison of Hope. Or to... maybe that's the guy that was trapped. I bet that's what that's for. I should go back and inspect that later. I'm betting he's like a merchant that can sell stuff back in town. Pure black tendency. At least that's the easy one. It's easy to make something pure black, right? It's a lot harder to get it to be white. Okay. I won't panic too much about using them. I also probably won't use them very often. Like, I almost never actually use them in my main playthrough, except to kindle bonfires. When I was main playthrough of Dark Souls, I should say. Alright. Okie dokie. Y'all aren't real, you're just statues. That's cool. Ooh, is this a shortcut? Similar little... nope, you're just a scary prison. You're totally maybe a shortcut. Or death. Could be death as well. Watch it just take me all the way to the bottom and I just die instantly. That'd be great. They use lighting to draw your attention to this. Oh, great! This is bringing back fantastic memories. What the fuck is that? Yikes. I don't know what you are, but you're not friendly. Yuck. Mercury stuff. Oh, and you make a wonderful noise, too. Jeez, I feel like getting back here is gonna suck. What's the big tentacles in the distance? Oh, man. OG Blight Town over here. That thing is way too big. Oh, just barely short of a one-hit kill there. Ouch. Can I check my tendency right now? There you go. Tower of Latria. Does that mean anything important to me? Yeah, I'm not a big fan of that tentacle. If you want to add that propagable, I think that you have the power to do it now. I think it's exclamation point, add quote, person's name, and then the text of the quote. It's going to do something. It makes a sound. Oh god. Okay. So, one of those big things. Thank God for sound design. I think it was silent, it would just hit you. I don't know what I just picked up. You knew what it was, let me know. I'll look for it later. Yeah. I like it about this level though. It's cool. Oh, really? Nice. That key, there's usually just nothing up there, unless if you're on the right world tendency. I don't really care for the world tendency system. I'm glad they removed it, especially since its workings are mostly hidden to the player. Fragant ring. What does that do? Recover MP. Okay, cool. So I have a. If I ever do pick up a spell, like, I might consider picking up a really cheap heal miracle. I did have that in Dark Souls, and it would be convenient in this one since it's based on MP and not a preset number of uses per checkpoint. Can you drop down from there? Doesn't look like it. Okay, I don't have any arrows to plink it to death. A miserable little pile of secrets. World tendency is a mechanic that adjusts either towards black or white based on events that happen in the game. Your world tendency becomes blacker if you die while you're in human form. Let's drop down. It becomes whiter when you kill bosses and when you kill invaders, like other players that jump into your game and fight you. When it's black, enemies deal more damage, they have more hit points, but they also give more souls and they drop more items. When it's white, they're a little bit easier, and there's certain world events that open, like there's certain items that are only accessible depending on which tendency you have, and nothing in the game that suggests to you which one is which, right? The closest thing to a tip is what other players enter. Oh god, there's another one. I don't like these guys. They freak me out. No loot. Can't tell if they're actually dead because of the little ragdoll effect. Yeah, it's a cool concept in theory. I think the problem with it is that there's two problems. One is that its mechanics are concealed from you. You don't really know how it works without looking it up. And two, it kind of works backwards. Like, you'd think that the game would get easier the more you die, the dynamic difficulty system, and harder the longer you live without dying. Don't stop. Oh god. We'll try running down that path after we murder these things. Big plus middle works. Yeah, I agree, Aiden. There's some similar ideas in No time to read messages. Similar ideas in Dark Souls that have a much better implementation, I think. Wonder if they poison you. If they hit you with their tail, they probably do. Probably build a poison meter that's not on the screen. These things' faces are creepy. They look like the mask of the father from Dark Souls. But it was their first time doing something, so they had to come up with an idea and execute on it. Farewell. Wonder if that's a boss. Dark Moon Grass? I've never seen one of those before. Fully heals HP and status ailments. Wonder if there's a catch to that. Yeah, it doesn't look like that's a boss fight. Although it could still be a boss fight, who knows? These recommendations. That's a lot of corpses. I wonder if that's telling us anything. Okay, there's still. Why so many I'm in troubles? Please recommend this messages. It's very worrisome. Be wary of the enemy spells. It's safe here. Oh, yeah, I hear a spell. Oh, I see. An invader version of this asshole? Great. Freaky deaky. Thank God for that little tip. I didn't realize that we get invader versions of monsters. Here's some wings flapping there. Okay. I not go up here? Just try to be wary. Whoa! Oh god. Dodged just the right time there. There's another one. Everything's fine. Just need to get some stamina back before we fight you. Cut their tail off. Dark World tendency means you have to fight a bunch of them. Yikes. A crystal lizard lies in wait ahead. Man, crystal lizards. I've come far enough in this level. I don't know if I want to go after it. Yeah, those things are freaky, man. I wonder if there's a spot where I can drop down to that message. Remember where it was. Let me go back and see where it was, see if I can deduce if it's a drop-downable kind of a situation. I can look directly up and see if there's like a hint. That's a big fat tentacle. It's actually right by the big tentacle, isn't it? Fortunately, I can't look straight up like a dog. Is it right underneath the tentacle? It's right past the tentacle. Yeah, crystal lizards in this game are there to troll you. Oh, you don't think I'll be able to drop into it? Right. There's treasure pit. Something about to spit shit on me? That's not cool. Look, they make sounds for a long time after they die. That thing can drop that way? Yes. Yeah, I don't think I'll be able to fall to it. I mean, there is a message we can see it from here. Maybe we get at it from a different direction. Something killed that thing. Oh, maybe it just fell. Still hear some wings flapping, and there's a ton of corpses here, which is worrisome. Come on. Come here, buddy. Yep. Oh, there's an enemy shooting at me. That's what that sound was. But I don't have any arrows to be able to fight him. Can I get him to come to me, though? I think I have seen lizards come back. I think there's certain ones that might not come back. I don't think we're fighting this guy without a bow and arrow. We'll have to pick up some more arrows next time we're in town. Oh, he's just following me now, I see. I don't know if I'm ever going to be able to fight him. He's flying way forward, and there's one above me there that I see. Two of them, and I'm going to get hit by the arrows too while I'm doing this, aren't I? Let's get some meter back. Phew! Starting to get worried there for a second. Okay. Left. So far, there have been remarkably few troll messages, except maybe that one that was like behind you, and then it drops right in front of you. What's this guy do? Think you can make that? Okay, don't try that. Roger. I'm actually kind of glad that there's not a jump mechanic in this game, because I was always stressed out whenever I try to make them in Dark Souls. Beware of a fall ahead. And I guess that thing is only down for a very short amount of time. 1,826 rating. predicament. That's a really tall elevator. Getting back here if we die is gonna suck. I don't think we've found a single shortcut. It's pretty much just been this whole area. And I really haven't had a chance to spend any of my souls. Bonfire system was a very, very smart idea. No harpy enemies attack us while we're on our way up the Tower of Terror. That is actually totally gonna happen. I don't want to fight them from here, but I might have to. I guess killing these things is a shortcut. Like, we won't have to do it again once they stop summoning, I think. Now I've done it. That was a really long climb, wow. Yeah, I think that this is making progress. We don't have to do this again. We just have to remember where all of them are. Were there just two, or is there a third one as well? There were just two, I think. Close enough now for us to be able to fight the giant monster heart. This is sort of like, what was the name of the monster in, gross. Oh, that's so cool. Yikes. What was the giant heart monster in the lava area in Dark Souls? That's disgusting. Okay, so are they implying that now there's more of those things because I busted the heart open and they were living inside of it? That's great if that's true. Alright, nothing to climb further up. There's a path over here, though. This is a one-way path, looks like. I see you, baby! Oh, nice dodge. There's another one near here too, I hear it up in its wings. Behind you. Thank you. Ceaseless Discharge, that's the one. Yeah. Okie dokie. Now what? Try to enjoy this area as much as possible. Oh, we're back to the entrance. Oh, cool. Okay. Well, I could take advantage of the fact that I've killed most of the enemies here, or I could go back and cash in my souls. I think I'm going to take advantage of the enemies mostly being dead, because I could pretty trivially get 11,000 souls just by farming that Reaper in World 4. So I shouldn't let fear of losing souls hold me back. If it happens, it happens, you know. Oh, well. I want to try to make it to the center now where that heart was. I'm actually not sure where it was relative to us on the map. Maybe if I look around I can figure it out. Yeah, Fetus of God, buried Silent Hill 3. Yeah, Sortus. I would hear that. Ceaseless Discharge would be a pretty good metal band name. Hey, now we've got these gross motherfuckers. That's some nice conveyance, actually. By killing the heart, they kind of show us what direction to go in, because we know that these guys popped out of it. Pretty good conveyance. Okay, so this place was probably... Oh, we used to see the heart beating in here, that's right. Now it's down on the bottom floor. Find a way to get down there. I am 36. Yeah, I thought you invaded and killed me. Maybe he's, like, jumping between the streams. Forgot. Alright, going down. I think there might be a door down here. Yeah, the gross scorpion monsters as conveyance as to which path to take once you've opened up the door. pretty cool. This feels right. So another one here? No, it's a dead thing. There's another one, and I heard it because of wearing headphones. Thank goodness for headphones. Oh, it drops it. Mercury stone. Yeah. Okay, shit's about to get super gross, I think. There are demons nearby, I think. I don't remember, was this room just not accessible before? I don't like that they keep making noises after you kill them. Ugh. Oh, there's a little baby. Can you not do that? Hey, jump right over my head. Good job. Gold mask, epi rapier. Okay. Sure. I'm not sure the high rank thing where it is. So it's just stats? It looks like it's heavier than what I've got right now. I could equip it, but it's not an upgrade. I'll have to look around for upgrades when we get back to town. Ring of Avarice. That better do what I think it does. Oh, fantastic. Alright, so we're gonna hold on to that. Somebody mentioned I didn't have to buy one from the merchant in this town, that I'd get one pretty soon. I will use that when I farm the Reaper. That'll be a good idea. Tons of loot down here. Very nice. Yep. Okay, man. Is that really just the point of doing this, is to get an Avarice ring? There's gotta be more to this level, right? There's probably gonna be a boss. There's a dead end ahead. Uh-huh. Some people's kids. Alright, so maybe it was just a bunch of sweet loot. Primarily, the sweetest of the loot being the, Ring of Avarice. So, has anything else about this map changed? I guess I could try climbing up. There may have been some paths that were blocked on the top because of the heart being connected. I'm guessing that's what we gotta do. We gotta climb now. Descending is just to get the items, mostly to get the Ring of Avarice. It's pretty sweet. But the bottom floor is definitely a dead end. Mm-hmm. I gotta say, this level is really cool. It's got the like Blighttown style swamp, but it wasn't a shitty. I guess the swamp wasn't the shitty part about Blighttown. It was getting down to the swamp that sucked. All right, any more bullshit up here? Yeah, I'm glad I didn't go back and cash in my souls. I have to fight these douchebags again. Aha, this was blocked before. Only I had some friends. Okay, so the death run for this boss actually won't be too bad. Because we can just kind of run directly into this room, just ignore all the enemies, maybe. Swamp is plenty shitty. Oh, hey. What's up? No. I do not want to fight one of those guys on this platform. So previously I couldn't climb this thing at all, right? Oh man, if I had some arrows. like the heart was blocking my path here, probably. It's safe here. Is it really? Oh wait, maybe we can sneak up on him now. So we got the last one. Yeah! Woo! That felt pretty good. I wasn't sure that was gonna work out. I told you so. I'm enjoying it very much. I have already played Dark Souls. I'm doing a blind playthrough of this one, and then once we beat it, we'll check out Dark Souls 2, Bloodborne, and Dark Souls 3. You'll find a souls past here. Mm-hmm. Do I go this way? Oh, cool. I told you so. I really left out the I told you so from Dark Souls. So I also am curious if the red enemies, True Demon Soul starts here. If the red enemies count as like mini bosses if they die permanently, you know? Why is there a stick? So I don't appear to be able to touch it. Right, got some deodorant. I think they actually mean that it's like ancient powder. I can't do the bloodstain. Maybe he goes in here and dies. Maneater. Oh, cool. Hey, what's up? Thing's freaky looking. I love the eyes and the breath. Nope. Ooh, gross. He does a Cthulhu attack. Whoa, shit. I didn't mean to attack twice. That was not on purpose. That was my bad. Oh, he's got a little snake tail. Freaky. Can't stagger him at all. Shouldn't count on that. Sometimes he just kind of stops, it looks like. If only he would fall, right? Pull a Taurus demon for me. Where'd he go? Oh shit, he flies around? That's not cool. I need a bow. There's that overhead attack paying off. Ooh, shit. That's never happened. Yeah, buddy. There's two of them now? Oh my god. That I didn't see coming. This is like the gargoyles. The one looks like the father. At least I can tell the difference between them. Can there not be two of them? I would very much like there not to be two of them. Ow. I need more grass for this fight, I think. I can win, I just need to be able to heal more. Ooh, shit! That's not good. Get out of dodge. Nope. Oh, I was trying to use my Stone of Ephemeral Eyes and I died. That's a bummer. Thank you, Aiden. Okay, I think I'm gonna need to have the Ephemeral Eyes. I might need to use one of those multiple times for that fight. Trying to decide if I want to go get some arrows for when he's flying around. I think I'm just gonna... Let's see what the run there is like. What kind of crap I have to put up with en route. I could probably do it without grass. I'd like to get a little bit of it at least. How much can I just avoid them if I run? And if I lose my souls, you know, shit happens. I thought that the one of them was going to be rough enough. Oh, shit. GG. Bye-bye. Right, Sornis? Alright, so straight running to the boss is not going to be an effective solution. We're going to have to at least kill that guy. It might be some more little scorpions that we'll have to take out in a similar fashion. Go, go, it's wrong. Knowing the right way would probably help, too. Don't care about those souls, because there's nothing there. Two hits. Now, well, I guess I'll find out. You don't have to tell me. But what I'm curious about is whether this boss that we're fighting, if the second Maneater spawns according to like the percentage of health he gets to, or if it's like the four kings, and if you can DPS him a lot, like the second boss spawns after a preset amount of time passes. The time one, you can try to be more aggressive at the beginning, so you're only ever dealing with one at a time. But it looked like I had the Maneater down to about 50% health when the second one spawned, so I'm not really convinced one way or the other. It looks like you can pretty much just run to him, though. That's nice. Assuming that the invader mind flayer doesn't respawn. Hey, Bruce Lee, how you doing? Be Friday or Saturday? He totally respawns, goddammit. That sucks. And then I die, right? Yep. GG. And then, well, at least I took him with me, right? Well, now I know. I guess maybe I can lure him out. I need to find an efficient way to kill this Mind Flayer. That gets me back into the boss fight quickly, because I imagine this boss being tricky for a while. There's not a lot of room to maneuver around. Is it just me, or does it take longer to use the Stone of Ephemeral Eyes than it does to use grass? I think what we'll do is we're gonna give the Maneater one more serious attempt, and when we die, we'll go and farm a little bit of grass, just so that I have maybe we'll do three or four runs. When I go off stream to farm grass, I'll do it with the Souls method y'all were talking about, killing the Reaper. But today I think it'll be more efficient to just do the area we had earlier. We'll maybe be able to give it one more attempt after that, and then it'll be a good time to start the next stream. Yeah, Gargoyles was a preset spawn, and the Kings was a timer spawn, so it could be either. I'm hoping it's the latter. Although the latter could be bad too, because if it's based on a timer and I do really poorly, like, I take a long time to do damage to him, we're going to find out really quickly. Yeah, please don't spoil it. It's cool. Just thinking aloud. Let's see. He turned around before. Maybe we just have to wait for him to do that. I feel like it would be best if I could manage to just, like, bull rush him and then attack him. I didn't see what was cleared in chat, but thank you for whoever cleared it. Yeah, no worries. I think he's just gonna keep walking. He's gonna turn around. Maybe if I come back with a bow and arrow, that might be the solution. I could also wait for him to walk all the way down, but that takes a while. Shit. Okie. Not gonna use his souls, but hey, why not? Bring more souls, Slayer of Demons. Okay. And do. I might throw in a debuff, or a buff on my weapon before I go in. Do I have an empty item slot? I do. What do we have? I guess we don't really have very many of these things. Is there a store where I can buy turpentine and sticky wife stuff yet? The throwing knife isn't really going to do me much good, I don't think. Range might not be bad for this guy. He's a little slow. Make some kind of questionable decisions, too. Sometimes he doesn't always attack right at you, you know? Oh, snake tail. Cool. Oh, I don't think we want to be close to him when he does that. I don't know what the deal is with it, but... Oh, now he's got a little poison mirror on his back. That's cool. Where'd you go, buddy? Oh, there you went. Where are you, buddy? Oh, there you are. Okay, if it's 50%, he's gonna spawn it soon, I think. Yeah, like now, right? Shit. Not good. It does take a little bit longer to trigger, so it's really not good for using in battle, it looks like. Sometimes. Yeah, I think he would have spawned by now if it was percentage health based. So I guess I can. Nope, it's not percentage health based, it's time. Alright. So we want to kick his ass much sooner next time. So we don't have to deal with two for as long. We have to try to track which one's which, too. Did we cut his tail off? I think we did. I didn't know that was a thing. Ow. Yup. Whew. Guy body blocked my attack there. Down to just one again, we might be okay. That's the other one. We got both of them there, so that's good. Whew, okay. Whoa. Can't see when you're doing a big death animation like that. Let's not mess around with that. Oh god. Come on, go ahead. Yep. Oh, you just flew. Okay. That's fine. As long as there's not three of them, right? That's great, if we can get him to get his attack stuck on the pillar. All about that. All day. Oh, he can break the pillars. Interesting. Where are you going, buddy? It's a long way to fly away. Oh, you're just trying to freak me out. That's what's going on here. Yeah, he falls off the ledge, he just starts flying. I'm not sure if this is true, but I feel like in Demon's Souls it's easier for you to change the direction of a swing once you've pressed the R2 button than it was in Dark Souls. Like, I feel like in Dark Souls, once you decided the direction, you were kind of locked in. But maybe that's not true. I'm just misremembering. Oh shit, I got greedy. Get me killed. His tail's gone too. Might just be based on his health total? Sure. I gotta let my stamina come back for a minute here. I'm gonna roll off the bridge, right? I can feel it. Maybe the best way to die against this son of a bitch. Alright, come on, come on. And sorry if I can't really pay attention to chat. This fight's a little intense. Shit. Big hit to the face, it's okay. Another big hit. It's alright, worse things have happened. Okay, I thought I rolled the timing there, apparently not. That timing. Ledge, which is fine. This guy seems to be mostly physical. I mean, he does that attack, which is a pain. Thank you for flying away for a minute and giving me a chance to heal, buddy. I appreciate that. I think he, like, stays still for a second once he does that dash attack, so you get a chance to hit him. Because he gets pretty far away from you. And you wouldn't really get a chance otherwise. Don't get greedy now, just because he's almost dead. Come on, buddy. Yeah, he, like, takes a second to think. The first one casts a lot of spells. I don't know if they both just cast spells the whole time or not. Whew! Oh, I should have gotten my BPM meter. It's bursting out of my chest. Yikes. Yeah, well, I think that went really well. It was a really good first. It was a second attempt on the boss, and I mostly got this world in a single pass outside of the invader. And, like, learning when it was best to suicide. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Oh, is this the end of the road? Oh, wait, no, there's more. Okay, let's go cash in these souls. I do percent one this time if you edit it, sir. Oh, that sucks, Spikey. That would be really shitty. I think that region is what saved my butt there, because I certainly didn't have enough healing items to take him on conventionally, but I was able to survive long enough for region to catch me up every time. Where are you at?
Thou seekest soul, then soul of the mind.
You know it.
Life's ether.
Oh, so close to one more.
Art thou done?
I can't sell stuff.
Thine strength help the world be mended.
Yeah. No, we'll see. I might try it, Sornus. I felt like the katana was a little bit too slow. This is just the right speed for me. I don't know, is Demon's Souls on PSN? I can't recommend this game enough, guys. Like, same thing goes for Dark Souls. I feel like if you've never played it before, even if you're not really into hard games, it's worth giving it a go. Like, I won't pretend like it's not hard, it is, and you have to be kind of patient, but it's remarkably rewarding in a way that I don't think another game that I've played has felt, when you finally push through and win.
Do come back.
Great sword's
alive.
Even slower.
Gotcha. Hello again. I'm keeping.
I see. Do I want to use this instead? Do I have the stats for it? I don't think I do. I think I've got 12 dexterity. I like the club, but I can't upgrade it, which makes me sad. Maybe I'll be able to upgrade it. If you guys just let me know, rather than me checking the blacksmith all the time. If I get a boss soul that would upgrade the club, just tell me when I find it. This all looks good to me. Gold mask, I'm not really too excited about. I'm gonna hold on to the Ring of Avarice all day. Probably hold on to these because they don't weigh a lot. If it comes up, it'd be nice to have. I think I picked this one up on Amazon on sale, Okami. You might be able to find it for sale on Amazon. Go check it out.
You have a heart of gold. Don't let them take it from you.
Okay. Oh, I should deposit those rocks. They weigh a lot. And I can craft out of them, which is amazing. One step ahead.
You have a heart of...
Oh man, I've used all of my grass at the plate. I wanted to see if I can get my armor up to a point where I'm taking advantage of my endurance. I can go up to 31 and a half. So let's see. I think the best thing is probably the helmet. The best thing is probably the gauntlets.
You have a
sword and board. I liked it when I first started using it. I really like canceling. Okay, that pushes us over. Pushes us way over. I think it'll be a ways before we can use this. We gotta get 5 more points of endurance.
I'm keeping.
Yeah, I'm probably gonna end up losing the souls anyway if I progress in that same map. Which I think I'd like to do. I think I want to go further into that next map. Trying to figure out weights here. What's our second heaviest? Try doing leather armor, or black leather. Let's see. Oh, really, Aiden? Okay, is it, do I talk to the, that's exciting. Do I talk to the blacksmith here, or is it the blacksmith that's in World 2? 124, okay, the leather armor is slightly better. Do that. I can almost do that. Okay, so I need to get one more level. Unfortunately. Oh, it just occurred to me that the Cling Ring is useless if you're not in soul form, isn't it? I guess it's probably correct to just put him away then. World 2? Yeah, the club was pretty fun. We'll hold on to these for now. I mean, they weigh a lot, but we're not at item
burden, have a so.
Oh, I can't craft the boss weapons just yet? Okay, thank you. We'll roll with this for a bit, and then we'll switch it up later. And go buy some grass so I can progress a bit further in the next world. Let's see. I think actually half moon grass is probably fine for now.
Nice.
21 is a lot, too. Especially for progression, maybe not so much for boss fights. Yeah, next session I'll probably do some trainings to get a better sense for the maiden. Mm-hmm. That's true, yeah. Well, I know that in general I'm not a big fan of, like, slow, heavy attacks, but maybe that'll change. We'll see. No. Cutscene? What? Oh, okay. I thought the game froze for a second. This place is freaky. What the shit is that? Oh man. He's so cool looking. Big flowing robes? Wow. That's cool. Is it like a super invader? What is it? Oh dear. I always get worried when the boss is the same size as me. Like, I could deal with really big bosses. Oh, isn't this thing in, isn't that in Dark Souls? It's like an invader. Oh, it's so freaky looking. Evil Pope who loves chairs gives his power to freaky invader. Chairman. All the while they're in this cutscene. Probably dump the cling ring for now, yeah? It's not doing me any good. Put it back on later. Guess we'll do Avarbus. Probably not gonna get to keep the souls, but... yeah, you can get that hat in Dark Souls. He's an invader that looks just like that. I didn't know that was a Demon Souls reference. It was like, that's a really specific costume. Oh, hey. What? You are not allowed to have super armor, buddy. That is the opposite of okay. Okay, he doesn't have super armor. He just takes a lot of hits to kill, some of which might be tendency. I think also I just got him in the middle of an animation that he did have super armor for. Shit, that's not good. Oh, here we go. Lucky me, managed to make a mistake there, trying to paralyze me twice. A trope for big enemies less threatening than small enemies? I bet there is. We'll probably find something on TV tropes. Oh, really? Oh, is it because... so I lost some for dying to the invader, but then I got it back for killing the boss, right? Count as a Black Phantom? Man. Don't like when those dudes have super armor. Okay. Once he starts ringing his bell, he's got super armor. Not looking forward to progressing further in this hallway. Took a risk there. That could have ended really badly. Yeah, exactly, Game Saucer. And maybe somebody can find the trope for it. They're the exception to magic being easier. Now they know they respawn too. Oof. Looks like that's where the dude is. So, let's just chill. I can use a half moon grass. I've got 20 of them. Got enough souls to get another ton of them. Old monk. Oh god. Let's not stand right in front of him when he's using his claw attack, huh? He just feels like an invader fight. It's cool. Listen well. I wonder if I can back attack him. That would be cool. You can parry Gwyn in Dark Souls. Surprising as that is. Totally can. Nice. Can I hit him when he's on the ground? No. Invaders are immune to that. Whoa! He's got little yellow magic boats. Let's see, he gets to summon one. Gotcha. Fortunately, they don't hit terribly hard, but they probably can stun you long enough for him to be able to hurt you. Oh shit. We got three of them that time. Let's heal. He just gets to summon them occasionally, looks like. Looks like I can stagger him enough. He's like at four now. Oh god, he rolled. Using them iframes. Shit. That's fine. This guy is like, it's worrisome because he's not really a big deal so far, so I'm afraid that he's going to become a big deal soon. He's got a really bitchin' hat though. Oh god, I'm gonna get hit by all five of those, aren't I? Yeah. I guess that's where he's an issue, since he's got five of them. Right, there's more to this, isn't there? Wait, seriously? Huh, okay. Old Monk's Trophy. Oh, okay. Right on. Oh, that's cool. Really, you can invade people here and it makes you into the boss? So do you have the helmet and everything? That's a really cool mechanic. Yeah, that's too bad. Why didn't that happen then? Is the game set up so that it's more likely for people who are invading to come in and take the boss's form? That's a bummer. I wish I could have fought another player in that segment. So long as they weren't allowed to heal. Yeah, that's too cool. If you beat a player there, you get the helmet. I see. Oh, that's too bad. Gotcha. Yeah, nice soul count, right? That's almost enough to wear the item I was going for. Yeah, I think we got up to 34, I want to say? Yeah, 34, unfortunately. So if we get two more levels, then I'll actually be at the soft cap. There's still people playing it. I guess that's a bit of a bummer. I would have liked to have experienced it with a player invading. I'm glad the servers weren't down, so at least there was a potential for it to happen. That's cool, though. One was pretty active. I feel like I got invaded quite a bit in that game when I was in human form. Okay, so Latria is done then. We still can, we can progress further now in World 1, which is what I'm going to do here. I'll go ahead and grab some of these grasses and stuff right here. Oh, I see. So you get really used to that cutscene. Yeah. The walk there is probably a pain with the two pain in the ass mind flayers on the way there. That would get frustrating. I guess I feel like I dodged a bullet, but I also missed out on something neat. Thank you guys for telling me about that. I don't think I would have realized that otherwise. Because of the red toots. Wow. Oh, so you can go to that area and then invade people? To try to... Maybe we'll do that before we finish this playthrough. Maybe I'll try to invade someone from there. Hey, it's this guy. This is the guy that was commanding the Iron Guardian before. What's up, buddy? We're friends now, right? God, why did you make your mask so freaking gross looking? That's just your face. What's the line from Red Letter B? What's wrong with your face? Why is that thing shaking? That's worrisome. Why are there so many corpses in here? That's also worrisome. Oh, there's dogs in there. Fantastic. Favorite enemies. Come on. Oh, I need to go back to Latria still. Oh, there's a good view. I need to go back to Latria and use that key that I found. Don't let me forget to do that before we beat the game. I want to see what's in there. We'll do it today. Storied soldier 7. Sucks to be these storied soldiers. Dead horses. Woof, 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 woof. Sleep shadow. Whoa. It's okay, frame rate. Everything's fine. You got this. Proud of you. It's safe here. Ah. In case that thing respawns, it'll be good. This guy is just too gross. Man, what a rude thing to do. Killing your own soldiers. Oh, it's bloodstained. These guys are still human. Sending his cronies over here. Hey dude, can I hit you from here? Probably not. We're gonna go see what's down at the bottom real quick. I'm curious what I missed there. Angry dogs. Really? Oh, this must be a shortcut for later. Okay, I see. Gotcha. I feel like the regenerating health, if you stack it, it kind of makes up for not having a traditional bonfire system. Because when you're just kind of running around in a general area, little bits of damage aren't as punishing. But I'm glad that they nerfed it and went with the Estus Flask system. I think I like that overall. It's more active having Estus Flask that regenerates at bonfires than having regenerating health. As I said, it kind of puts you in this mode where you feel the correct play is just stand around and wait for your health to come back, and that's not fun to do. I want to try to make it so the correct play is always something that's fun, if possible. Looking at you, Final Fantasy XIV Relic Quest. Let's go get these dudes. Expect shooting me. Oh, you get to shoot me on the ladder? That makes sense, but it's irritating. Well, that is in fact a dead end. I hear people walking. Ow! Walked right into that. Good. Got 20 of them. New moon grass, oh, that's new. Oh good, you can drop over that, okay. Good. The classic, the table is protecting me from damage trope. There's another dude around here too, right? Like above me. Whoa. Oh, you're throwing shit. And you've got really good... I wonder if those are poison. There's not an on-screen buildup for poison in this one, I don't think. No! Holy shit! I think that everything else you would do would hurt you more than him kicking you in the face. That is incorrect. Face kick hurts really badly. Secret throwing dagger. Oh man, I like all of those words. Yup, that's an enemy ambush! Only could have used that on the guy before, right? Beans. Someone else is shooting at me. I'm not sure who they are. That's who they are. I think they were just like doing a little pose, showing off. I'm so fancy. Hey, what's up? Oh god. I think I've seen that guy before, maybe. Let's lure him into this long hallway. Oh, those things can travel. Shit. Hey, come on. Nope, that's not what I wanted you to do, camera button. God. That's why I don't trust you. You want to build trust. I still need to kill one of these rockin' knight-looking dudes. Red-eye knights, I guess they're called. There's one that I skipped forever ago in, like, the very first level. Nope. Come in. Come here. You get to drink? That's rude. Alright. Got stuck on my head there. What is a new moon grass? Recovers all HP. Okay, so dark moon grass is the best. Not only does it recover HP, it's like an elixir remedy. It's even better. There was somebody else in here, wasn't there? Totally is. Shit. I just killed this gnarly looking red eye knight guy. I'm not gonna let you kill me. I'm pushing me by the door. Using totally legitimate strategies. Hidden passage. Okay. So I'm going to continue playing Demon's Souls today. We're at time, but I'm going to keep going either until the next save point or until we die. And then we'll sign off, so. Either the next boss or the next time we see you died. Cut it. Said hidden path. I think that was it. They were just talking. Maybe it's further along the way in here. I think all the hidden paths in this one, you've got shimmery walls. Hey, I'm just gonna go a little bit over. I'm playing Demon's Souls because I beat Ghost Trick. So I'm gonna play until I get to a save point or die, so it should be like 10-15 minutes.
Ah, we hope you find something that suits you.
Me too. Alright, your shit's expensive. You do sell turpentine though, which might be nice later. Oh, he sells some cool stuff. What's a claymore? Strength, 20 strength. How much is it? 6,000? Only weighs 6. I might want to try the claymore out. Maybe. Oh, he sells crossbow bolts, but I'm not using those. Coat of plate. Heavy as shit. When it says its heaviness impedes stamina regeneration, does that mean that, like, it actually impedes stamina regeneration, or does it just mean it's more likely to bring your endurance score down? Ooh, great sword. I'm gonna have to pay for one after all. Oh, there was a way to turn left here? Okay. Really like the claymore. Whoa, that guy doesn't stop. Don't think we want to fight him out here. It's probably a bad decision. Fight him in here, though. Get him? Yeah, that's a ticket. It actually does impede it? Okay, then I am not interested. Hey dudes. Oh, do I actually get to fight you now? This guy's been teasing me forever. Thought he was gonna end up being the boss or something. He's shooting me through walls. Super rude. Come on. Yep, you just keep sauntering over here. Saunter, saunter, saunter. Is this the same as the... Well, I guess he is. I guess he's technically the same as the level 2... that officials, I think we said their name was, right? Maybe he's not actually a fancy enemy at all, he's just haunting us. Cool. Oh, wait, no, Iron Ring of Keys. They all look the same, okay. not. Oh shit, that's not good. Let me go heal real quick and then we'll go finish murdering those dudes. Yeah, I like reach. Finding that that's something that I'm really a fan of. I think that's why I like the Iaito katana so much in Dark Souls. Because I could do that like running thrust attack. That was really useful for if people would invade me, like people would almost always underestimate how much range I actually had with the thrust. There's a lot of dudes. Why don't we take them on one at a time? Come on. Come on. Or not, yeah. That's cool. What else? Nope. Thought I could be fancy. It's called a choke point. Sun Tzu would be proud. Sure if the dash attack with the Iaito was unique to that particular weapon or if some of the other katanas did the same thing. It was like a really long-ranged thrust. That was the only one I really used in my playthrough. Poor guy. Got his booty butts kicked. Hey, what's up? Oh god, there's one right behind me. One of the frickin' thieves. Oh shit, nope. Oh, not good. Chill it on the hubris there, Marstead. I said chill it on the hubris. Can't hit from that far away, buddy. Dang it. Oh, the katanas have the same move. Gotcha. I'm trying to remember what weapon I saw most frequently online. You can hear the fire as they head to the trap, right? Yup. Got a halberd. I used the halberd a bit in my second playthrough of Dark Souls, my sorcerer character, and I actually enjoyed it quite a bit. Beware of the formidable foe ahead. The size of this area is distressing. Not a dragon flying around or something, is there? I could probably go back and kill that dragon too, right? Took a risk there, totally worth it. Eat it, formidable foe. Get better eardrums, buddy. Haha. Number one weapon against archers is a wall. Yep, just stand there and stare at me while I murder your friends. It's a proven strategy. Proven strategy. Like halberds, yeah. Okay. Probably gonna turn a corner and have to deal with some bullshit here soon. Rate you. Indeed. Yeah. Well, it is, technically, right? It's the first world. We just weren't allowed to progress here until after we killed an archdemon. Yeah, the enemies are all very straightforward. Would've put a guy behind that wall. Starting to see the code. Blonde, brunette, redhead, bullshit ambush. Try falling through? Falling through what? Oh, world tendency is low here? I see. Or white, I should say. Yeah, the one place my world tendency sucks is the place where it's gonna be really hard. Oh, this is the guy who was taunting me the whole time. Hey, buddy. You've been a dick for a while now. Not a recent phenomenon. Oh, you get super armor when you're bringing your axe down. That's good to know. Official's cap. Oh, shortcut. Awesome. I could try that six gun. I'll go back up and check real quick. Yeah, I don't know. Oh. Oh. I mean, walk off the ledge there. That's cool. I don't know why you would do that, though. I'm looking down here. Interesting. I guess it's just a way to get down. Skip some enemies. Yeah. There's still a shortcut over here that I haven't opened yet. Or not here. Back the other way. Maybe it'll be another one that we'll get to. Yep. I feel like the radius on enemy firebombs is much lower than it was in Dark Souls. It's a lot easier for me to just ignore. What do you say? I'm lost. Thank you. What's up? Let's just chill for a minute. Nope. Bad decision. Yeah. No, I definitely wanted to know. I saw it in the menu. It's a really weird inclusion. I'm not going to worry about it too much. Glad to know that the mechanic exists, though. Okay, I'm wondering if that fog door is the boss. It seems like a bunch of enemies that I could potentially run past. I need to get to you later. Ooh. Every enemy is a threat in Souls games. Yeah, it doesn't give you any hint as to how it works. I guess you could maybe figure it out. You'd probably figure out how it goes dark. Maybe not how it goes white. Yeah, keep stunning me with your crossbow bolt. That's super swell. I had to hit by another one, too. Oh, maybe not quite. Alright. Yeah, was it a manual thing? I guess this game is old enough that... Well, there's some stuff in Dark Souls that doesn't get described either. Like, the humanity system isn't really explained in-game, as far as what you need to do to kindle bonfires, and that's a really important mechanic, significantly more so than world tendency, I would say, as far as being able to progress successfully. I'm gonna get killed with crossbow douchebags. Uh-oh. Oh, there's other more different axe douchebag. Okay. It's okay, all you adds can come over here, I'm fine. I need to reduce the amount of range damage that's incoming. Oh, you're all red-eyed knights. That changes things a little bit. Shit. Can we not get shot in the back? What's the range on those douchebags? Whoa! They get to charge with their spear? That's not good for me. Oh, these guys suck. I need range, a bow to deal with them. Try isolating some of them. I think they're just gonna chase me forever, though. Try to get some back attacks in would be nice. Oh, and they get multiple hits! Oh my god. Screw these guys. My death is imminent. Yikes. Can I just skip them here? Yeah, that's the way to go. Not worth it. Okay. Oh, it didn't work the way I was hoping it would. I was hoping I would be able to get a back attack in on that. There's a dude down here! There's a dude down here. I don't know when he got down there, but he's there. Hello. What's up, friend? We're good. Bye. Yeah, I could probably block them. You're probably right. That's the way to deal with the roly-poly douchebags, too. They are not meant for a roly-poly douchebag like myself. Are the guys still coming for me? They might be. Oh, hey, welcome back, Death Ghost. Totally different Death Ghost, by the way. That's too bad. I wanted to be able to fight the boss, but I think Death Ghost is gonna kill me here. He's Death Ghost 12, right? Different number. Common name. Oh, I can make him go away by going to the boss fight? Oh, that's cool. Right on. Is that true in Dark Souls 2? I don't think I ever was close enough to a boss door to attempt it. I thought it would lock me out. Cool. That's pretty sweet. Yeah, different guy entirely. Just a coincidence, right, Spiky? Oh, freaky music. Ow. That's cool. You do a cool sword thing. Let's see. You have a cool name too, Penetrator. I'm trying to learn his moves here. I wonder if I can back attack him. Getting behind him is easier said than done. If I can back attack him, I probably have to do a better job at maneuvering. Ouch. Nope. His moveset is actually kind of similar to Ornstein, but he's only by himself at the moment, so if he gets a buddy, then I'm worried. Oops. Okay, that move, we gotta be more careful with rolling. Plenty of these grasses, I may as well use them. Sometimes he follows up, and sometimes he doesn't, it looks like. Ouch. And one time he attacked, I was actually under him. Worked out very well for me. Try the running strategy of not having him locked down. It seems like I can get behind him pretty easily. Yeah, it looks like I cannot back attack him, which is too bad. Or maybe I just positioned it slightly wrong. Hit him, though. Yeah, who needs lock on, right? There is another fight, it might have been Manus in Dark Souls that I did better on because I didn't lock on. Ouch. I meant to go behind him there. Yep, I've made that mistake several times now. Just try not to roll, maybe we just run. Maybe that's a better way to respond, maybe not, actually. Got a whole bunch of new grass I can try, too. It's not in my preset options, though. Nope. That was not a hit. Oh, shit. I got greedy there, but he swung his second sword over my head. That was luck. Not skill. He's got a reach, so at least we've got reach to match, right? Excuse you, Ben. Oh god. Ben, can you not sit directly in front of the monitor so I can't see a third of the screen? Ben's gonna be the one that kills me, right? Can't quite get the reach on him, I guess, that, unfortunately. Shit. Ben, I can't see my items, buddy. Ah! I tried to speak him out of the way. Phew. Come here, dude. I had to delay my dodge a little bit on that attack, and then I can get him. I swear it's much easier to change the trajectory of your swing in this game after you press the attack button. It makes a ton of difference. I hope it doesn't, like, spoil me for Dark Souls 2. Or I'm not gonna be able to get away with it, you know? It's okay, framerate. You'll be good. I'm guessing that big charge attack he does hurts really bad if he lets you hit him. Oh, we were doing so well. I thought we were gonna have him on the first try. I made a mistake. I got too greedy. I rolled in the direction of his second swing. Yeah, right, Serp? The help of cats. It would take a really long time for me to attempt him again. I kind of want to attempt him again, but we'll open next Demon's Souls stream with a successful attempt versus that guy. Yeah, 2 Bloodborne and then 3. That's too bad. That's just an issue of don't screw up. I also had an opportunity to heal in that fight and I chose not to, which was, I should have been more conservative. Rock and roll. Well, thanks guys for hanging out. Fun as always. We'll see if we can find someone playing Demon's Souls to throw a host over to. One sec here.